Welcome to tonight's performance. In order to fully engage with the art of live theater, please take a moment to power down all electronic devices. The use of any video, audio, or photographic recording device is strictly prohibited by law. For the safety and comfort of performers and audience members, masks are required in all areas of the MVHS campus. We are also employing a one-way traffic flow. Please exit to your left and re-enter from the right. To everyone joining us in person and via live stream, thank you for supporting the Velvet Curtain Dramatic Society. Enjoy the show. Thank you.
going on, Gwen?
Hi, I like you. I think I like you. Hi.
Stop that! Get away! What is this, Gwen? What's the story, Gwen?
The park?
Back up, please. You were sitting in the park. When were you sitting in the park? Oh, Gwen. Oh, Gwen. Sylvia?
Sylvia.
Why Sylvia?
The name on her tag. See? Sylvia.
What else is on her tags?
Nothing. Locate. Just Sylvia. She was lost and abandoned.
Sylvia.
Hi, Kate. See? She knows it. She answers to it. Don't you, Sylvia? I do. I definitely do.
What a name for a dog. Sylvia. She of the woods has fleas.
I'll deal with that. I'll get her all checked up.
Why, Gwen?
To deal with the fleas.
No, I mean, why a dog, darling?
Why not?
In the city, Gwen?
I like dogs.
I know you do, sweetheart, but here, now, with the kids gone?
I love dogs. I love you. See, she connects immediately. She latched right on.
I'm latching right off, Gwen. Sweetheart, I'm exercising a veto. I'm saying no to Sylvia.
No?
N period, O period. Not in New York, not at this stage of our lives, no! You work all day, I work all day, we go out a lot.
Out? Did I hear out?
We're going out tonight, as a matter of fact.
I love that word, out. Tonight?
The Waldmans have to get to a chamber music concert, so we're meeting them from dinner and then going to that. And tomorrow night we have our Spanish lessons, and on Saturday we're going to the Knicks game with the Creamers, so no, no, Sylvia, there's no need.
I have a need.
What need? What do we do?
I don't know. I hate situations like this. I've been caught in the middle before, and I just hate it.
What is she? A mutt?
I think she's part lab.
She's a mutt.
No, she's got a lab's disposition. You like everybody, don't you, Sylvia? I do, everybody. My aim in life is to please. I think she may also be part poodle. Mais oui, monsieur. Ooh la la.
She's not the prettiest thing I've ever seen, Gwen.
That's what I like about her. You've got hybrid vigor, don't you, Sylvia? You are multicultural. You better believe it. Think of her as an American, Kate. Canis Americanus. That's Sylvia. I pledge allegiance. I solemnly swear.
Is she house trained?
I think so.
You think so? Probably isn't.
You were a good girl on the way home, weren't you? Yes, I was. I was very good. You were a good girl on the bus, weren't you?
I may puke, Gwen. Seems to me someone else around here is behaving like a poor lost soul. I'll get it. Oh, yes, Harold. She's right here. He wants to talk to you. He's your boss, for God's sake. He sounded a little mad, Gwen. I hope you apologize for leaving work in the middle of the day. Oh, yeah? Why? Oh, come on.
Hi.
Go away, Sylvia.
Hello, Kate.
Sylvia.
I'm just trying to make friends.
Don't bother me, please. I'm trying to prepare my fall curriculum.
You don't like me, do you?
It's not a question of that.
You don't like dogs?
I like them when they belong to other people.
You're prejudiced.
Not at all.
I think you're prejudiced against dogs.
I am not prejudiced, Sylvia. When I was a girl, I read the Albert Payson Terhune dog books cover to cover. I watched Lassie on television. I'm a huge fan of 101 Dalmatians. When we lived in the suburbs, when the children were around, we had several dogs, and guess who ended up feeding the damn things? I don't want a dog now, Sylvia. That is the point. Our last child has gone off to school, and we've moved into town, and the dog phase of my life is definitely over. I've gotten my master's degree, Sylvia, and I have a very challenging teaching job, and quite frankly, I don't want to have to worry about animals. So if you'll excuse me, I will return to the daunting task of planning how to teach Shakespeare in inner-city junior high school.
Okay, fine. No problem. I'll just stay out of your hair.
Off, Sylvia.
You speaking to me?
I said off that couch right now.
I'm just relaxing. Can I even relax?
Now off, and stay off.
Easy, take it easy. Jesus.
I'm sorry, but you've got to learn.
I've sat on couches before, you know.
What?
I've sat on couches before. I've sat on plenty of couches.
Well, you can't sit on this one.
Oh, hoity-toity you.
Quiet, I'm working.
Can I at least sit on this chair?
No, Sylvia. Off.
Shit, piss, crap.
This is not going to work, Sylvia.
What do you mean?
I'm afraid you'll have to go to the pound.
Hey, I'm sitting, aren't I? I'm sitting on the floor. Look how quickly I sat.
Still, you've got to go.
All right, I get the picture. I'll avoid the furniture. I'm not dumb.
No, I'm sorry, Sylvia. You're going to the pound. I'm sure someone will come along and give you a nice home.
But I've got a nice home right here.
No, now listen, Sylvia. It just doesn't make sense. No one's around all day long. You'll be bored out of your mind stuck in this apartment.
I don't mind. I'll sleep. I'll chew things.
That's just the trouble.
All right, then. I won't chew things. Just tell me the rules and I'll follow them. I swear.
We go out a lot, Sylvia. We visit the friends in the country on the weekends. We see the kids at college.
I'll come too.
No, I don't want that. I want my freedom, Sylvia. My freedom from dogs. Now you'd be much happier somewhere else.
In the pound?
Well, not the pound, really. I shouldn't have said the pound. We'll give you to, what is it? The Animal Rescue League. Or the Humane Society.
They suck.
Oh, now.
They do. They suck. You have no idea what they do.
I'm sure they make every effort.
Have you ever been there? Have you ever bothered to check them out?
No, but
the rows of cages, the shitty food.
No.
The time limit.
The time limit?
Oh, they all have time limits. They don't broadcast it, but they do. If someone doesn't bail you out, normally within 5 working days, then they put you to sleep.
Sylvia.
They do. They kill you. Listen, it's a tough world out there, lady. I know. I've been there. That's why I want to be here.
Well, you can't, Sylvia. I'm terribly sorry, but I must put my foot down.
Hey, Sylvia, baby.
I love you! I love you!
How'd it go with Harold, Gwen?
We agreed to disagree.
Oh, Gwen.
He keeps wanting to shift me into the money market.
What's wrong with that?
I'll tell you what's wrong with that. It's too abstract. That's what's wrong with that.
I don't see why.
Look, Kate, I liked manufacturing. Starting off in product development, I liked that. I could see what we were making, I could touch it, I could tinker. And I liked selling too when they bought me up to sales. I could still picture the product in my mind. Okay, so then, they acquire an investment company and they told me to trade. I try, I study up, I learn about oils, soybeans, corn. I read the data, I figure the trends, and I do okay. Not great, but I get by. But now, they want me to trade currencies, Kate. Money markets, derivatives. I can't do that, sweetheart. What's behind currencies? Other currencies. What's behind those? Who knows? Nothing to see, nothing to get a purchase on. And that's what I mean when I say it's too abstract.
Don't lose your job, Gwen.
It wouldn't kill me.
The kids would have to quit school.
That wouldn't kill them.
Oh, Gwen!
I'm not so sure college is the answer to everything in life.
You went to college!
That's why I'm not so sure!
Oh, for God's sake!
If they really want college, they'll find ways of paying for it. They might get more out of it that way, too.
Can't believe I'm hearing this.
Neither can I. That's what makes it so exciting.
So how'd you leave it with Harold?
I told him to put me in something real.
Real? What's real?
Sylvia's real, aren't you, Sylvia?
Oh, I could try to be!
Down, Sylvia! Make her get down, Gwen!
Down, Sylvia!
She'll ruin your clothes!
Don't drop off, Sylvia!
Sorry, I went a little overboard there.
At least let me try her, Kate.
For how long?
A few days, at least.
All right, for a few days.
Oh, yippee! Yay! I sense a change in the weather here.
For a few days, we will try, Sylvia, in the fervent hope that you'll realize how dumb it is to take on a dog at this point in our lives.
Fair enough, Kate.
You're happy, I'm happy.
No, now wait. I want to make one thing clear. She is yours, not mine. I won't walk her, I won't feed her, and I don't want her jumping onto the... What is that?
What's what?
That puddle. She's peed, Gwen.
Did you do that, Sylvia?
I won't dignify that with a response.
Of course she did that.
I'm not saying a word.
She was nervous, Kate. Strange place, hostile environment.
That's it. That was the problem.
You should punish her, Gwen.
I can't punish her. It's too late to punish her.
I love this woman. I adore her.
Rub her nose in it, at least. She's got to learn.
I won't do that, Kate.
Hey, hey, hey.
Quiet, you.
I'm getting nervous. I might bite.
No, now relax, Sylvia.
At least clean it up, Gwen.
Glad to.
This is slightly embarrassing.
Honestly, springing a dog on me this way.
There. All cleaned up, see? Not a trace.
Wasn't there. Didn't happen.
You've really thrown me for a curve here, Gwen.
Tell you what. We'll go out.
Out? Now?
Out? Did I hear out?
I meant Sylvia.
Oh.
Knew it! Can't wait! Love going out!
Let's go out, Sylvia.
What about the Waldmans?
The Waldmans?
Dinner? The concert?
Take Betsy in my place. She loves concerts.
Sweetheart.
Sylvia needs to go.
I'm worried, Gwen. I'm worried about your job, I'm worried about you, and I'm worried about us.
I'm worried about Sylvia at the moment.
I must be cruel, only to be kind. Thus bad begins and worse remains behind. Hamlet, Act 3.
Sylvia, the park where we met, remember?
I'm nervous.
No, don't be. You're in your element now. This is nature. This is your natural habitat.
I'm still nervous.
Look at those other dogs.
I see them.
This is called Dog Hill. They let dogs play freely here. Now go play, Sylvia.
Hey, stop pushing.
Then there's your group. There's your pack. Call the wild, kid.
I know all that.
And you need the exercise.
Look, it's no easy thing wading into a new group. They could gang up, or ignore you, or even bite. I notice you're not barging into that group of dog owners over there.
You have a point.
So, let me take my own sweet time.
Go on, play, run around. Good girl.
Hiya.
Hello.
New around here?
Just got a dog.
That one yours?
Right.
Cute.
Thanks.
Cute little butt on her.
I agree.
That's my golden sniffing around her.
Good looking dog.
His name's Bowser.
He looks like a Bowser.
He is. He is definitely a Bowser.
Mine's called Sylvia.
Sylvia? Uh-oh.
You don't like the name Sylvia?
Might cause problems.
Why?
Give a dog woman's name, you begin to think of her as a woman.
Oh, yes?
That can be dangerous. Which is why I go for doggy names. Spot, Fido, Bowser. Sylvia, that can spell trouble.
Oh, come on.
Maybe I'm just associating. I had a girl named Sylvia.
Was she good looking?
No, she was a dog.
Looks like they're having a good time out there.
Sylvia and Bowser. Easy, Bowser. Go slow. Sylvia Spade.
She's a stray. Haven't had her checked out yet.
Don't let them spare till you're sure she's been in heat.
Don't?
It's a feminist thing. You're supposed to let her experience how it feels to be female. That way, she'll retain a sense of gender later on.
Ah,
There's a book on the subject called Plano Spay Later. I'll bring it to you next time I come to the park.
Thanks.
Just touching base here. Just touching base.
Having a good time, Sylvia?
The best.
Do you like Bowser?
I think he's absolutely fantastic.
Then go back and play.
May I?
Sure, kid. Go on. Shoot.
Oh, boy. Ready or not, Bowser, here I come.
She's a little insecure there, isn't she?
What makes you think that?
The way she checks back with you.
She loves me. She thinks I saved her life. I'm her knight in shining armor.
Uh-oh.
What now?
You married?
Sure. Why?
Wife fond of Sylvia?
Not yet. Why?
Kids out of the nest.
Right. Why?
Be careful.
What do you mean?
You can get lost in it.
Oh, yes?
Sure. Wife sends it out. They know it. My wife feels very threatened by it.
She does?
Oh, God, yes. And I imagine it's worse with yours.
Why?
Well, no offense, but you're older. When you're older, it can become major.
Think so?
Sure, something to hold on to on the way down.
Oh, no.
Look, single people with dogs, no problem. Dog is basically another friend to them. But for us, it's different. When I come home at night, I have to remind myself to kiss my wife before I say hello to Bowser.
Mm-hmm.
I even think about him at work. I keep wanting to call him up and chew the fat. I don't think it's a gay thing, but I love the guy.
I can relate to that.
And they say it's even worse if your dog's female.
Really?
There's a guy around here, had a dog named Debbie. Half basset, half beagle. Sweet little thing. His wife walked in on him giving Debbie a bath and got so jealous she gave the dog away.
Christ, what did he do?
Sued her for damages. The judge was a dog owner and came down on his side. He said a man and his dog is a sacred relationship. What nature hath put together, let no woman put asunder.
So what happened?
Well, the guy got Debbie back, and his wife back, and they all tried moving to Vermont, but still not good. Someone visited them recently and said it reminded them of the last chapter of Ethan Frome.
Good lord.
There's a book on the subject called Your Pooch and Your Partner. It is one basic bit of advice. Always remember that your dog is simply a dog. Always keep reminding yourself of that fact. Not a person, just a dog. Force yourself to think it. Otherwise, you can get into deep dog shit.
Gotcha.
Well, I better be off. You might want to hold Sylvia back so she won't follow Bowser.
Oh, she won't do that.
She might. Bowser brings out the beast in them.
We're home.
Love that we.
Well, we are.
You're late again.
I lost track of the time.
That's the third time this week.
Time is for slaves, Katie.
Time is for people who have things to do. I have an evening meeting.
In the middle of August?
They're deciding to try a pilot program for my new English curriculum.
What? Hey, congratulations. You're turning into a big cheese.
I try.
You do more than try. You succeed, baby.
Let's hope so. Anyway, I had to eat dinner early. The microwave stands waiting.
Fine.
Where's Saliva?
Her name is Sylvia, Kate.
Where is she?
She's a little hyper at the moment. I put her in the other room.
No wonder things seem so peaceful.
Hey, before you go, I've got a surprise for you.
A surprise?
Remember how I said Sylvia was a little hyper?
I vaguely recall that observation, yes.
Let me show you why.
I haven't got much time, Gwen.
Ta-da! Come on, Sylvia! I had her professionally groomed.
Look at me! Look at me! How do you like them apples?
They gave her the full treatment. Ears cleaned, nails clipped, flea dipped, the works.
Really?
They even evacuated her anal glands.
Spare me, Gwen!
Oh, fine. But the girl who groomed her said she thought she was basically a French poodle. She was crawling with fleas. You were right about that, Katie. But look at her now. Isn't she spectacular? Don't you want to keep her now?
Off, Sylvia.
Oh, come on.
Off, Sylvia. I don't want her on the furniture, Gwen. Off, Sylvia.
Smell her, Kate.
I do not want to smell her.
No, really. She smells great.
I can
smell her.
I can smell her from here, sweetie.
Then don't you agree she smells great?
She smells like a lavatory in an airplane.
Oh, Kate.
All right, a lavatory in first class.
At least you admit she's a class act.
Enchantée, madame.
I've really gotta go, Gwen.
But just look at her, isn't she gorgeous?
Don't, Gwen, if you can possibly help it. I'm spending my days teaching children the liberating possibilities of Shakespeare and all his majesty and glory. I'd prefer not to come home to a dog.
Dig her.
She's tired. She works hard.
She doesn't like me.
She will, Sylvia.
She makes me nervous. I sense the clock ticking away.
She just takes her time with things. Hey, it took her 2 years to say she'd marry me.
2 years? Jesus, Gwen, if you multiply that by 7, why that's... carry the 2. I make that 14 years. Dog time. That is too long, Gwen.
She's worth it, Sylvia, I promise.
But isn't there anything I can do to speed things up? I'm tired of feeling like a house guest around here. I want to feel totally at home.
She'll come around, Sylvia. She just is a little career-oriented at the moment. It's a phase she's going through these days. Come on, let's see what there is for chow.
Simple and convenient. Anybody home? No? Thank God. They must be at the park for the umpteenth time. Don't even get me started, Phyllis. But how lucky we were to run into each other on the street.
That's New York for you, the biggest small town in the world.
I'm discovering that.
Well, now that you and Gwen are here, Hamilton and I want to give you a small dinner party.
Wait!
What?
Not there. You'll ruin that nice jacket. She leaves these great grubby hairs.
Who?
Sylvia.
Sylvia?
The dog.
Oh. You let the dog onto the couch?
I do not. I absolutely forbid it, but she... I'd prefer not to talk about it.
Good for you. We New Yorkers all have parts of our lives we keep to ourselves. I mean, we all have private parts. I mean...
You haven't changed since Vassar, Phyllis. I hear you and Hamilton are the toast of the East Side.
Oh, well, we circulate. Who would you like to meet? Kitty Carlisle Hart? Charlene Hunter Galt, Boutros Ghali.
Anyone with pull in the New York schools.
Fine. I'll organize an evening which will focus strictly.
She waits, you know. She literally waits until I'm out the door and then she leaps onto the couch.
Who?
Sylvia. And when she hears my key in the latch, she jumps off.
Are you sure?
I am. Once I snuck back in and caught her red-handed.
I hope you punished her immediately.
I tried, but she practically laughed in my face. She only listens to Gwen.
Then Gwen should punish her. Dogs are like children. They need to be thoroughly disciplined from the ground up.
Gwen, punish Sylvia. Don't make me laugh.
Let's talk dates for the party. Hamilton and I are booked solid through October, but how about November 6th?
Fine.
Good. There are no friends like...
I have the strong suspicion that when I'm out of the apartment, they sit on the couch together.
Gwen and Sylvia?
They do everything together. Once I caught them sharing an ice cream cone.
How disgusting.
And Sylvia uses Gwen's hairbrush. I mean, Gwen uses it on Sylvia.
Hamilton has taken up goldfish.
At least they stay in their bowls.
Not necessarily.
What?
Sometimes he takes them into the bathtub.
No!
I swear! If you ask him, he'll deny it, but I swear I caught him at it.
Good Lord!
Look at us. Here we are talking about animals when we should be planning our party.
You're absolutely right, Phyllis. How about a drink? What would you like? Wine? Vodka? What?
Just fizzy water, please. I'm trying to give up alcohol.
Good for you. I'll get them.
So fill me in on this school thing, Kate. I saw Madge McKenzie at the Colony Club, and she says you're roaming around Harlem reciting Shakespeare.
Thank you.
That's why I want to meet people with pull, Phyllis. I want to put Shakespeare into the junior high curriculum.
Is that possible? I mean, at that age? I mean, these days? I mean, up there?
I hope so, Phyllis. If we can hook kids in junior high, we might have them for life.
I wish I could believe that, Kate.
It's not just Shakespeare, Phyllis. It's language in general. These kids are fascinated by words. They rap, they rhyme, they invite these exciting new phrases and metaphors just the way Shakespeare did. If we can take their curiosity and imagination and energy and give them words, more words, good words with significant context, then maybe she wants to sleep in our bed, you know.
Sylvia?
Sylvia wants to sleep in our bed.
You said no, I hope.
Of course I said no, not even outside the covers.
I should hope not.
But Gwen fought me all the way and continues to on every issue. When we visited our friends, the Wilkins, up in Williamstown, she insisted that Sylvia come with us. But it was our anniversary, Phyllis. How would you like to be driving through all that lovely New England scenery with Sylvia drooling down the back of your neck?
I see your point.
And when we got there, the Wilkins put us all in the same room.
You and Gwen and Sylvia?
There we were, holed up together. Gwen and I spent our wedding anniversary with Sylvia wandering restlessly around the room, peering over the bed and panting.
How horrible.
I mean, here I am, breaking my back, trying to instill some sense of civility in American life, and she drinks from the john, you know.
Sylvia.
Sylvia drinks from the toilet. Sometimes, when we're trying to have a decent dinner, you can hear these great gulping sounds coming from the loo.
Good heavens.
And then she comes slobbering back in, sitting by the table, and eyeing us all throughout the meal.
You see? They're like children. They need to be exiled while we eat.
Don't I wish. But how about a refill, Phyllis?
I'm fine.
I might just shift to a little scotch.
Now be careful, Kate. Don't start leaning on liquor. Take it from one who knows. It's the curse of our generation. It's the curse of our particular ethnic group.
Gwen takes Sylvia out to lunch, you know. She does. She dashes home at noon and they go out to lunch. She's found some restaurant on Amsterdam Avenue that's willing to serve Sylvia.
I'm appalled.
And lately, she's been taking the afternoons off.
Hamilton does that sometimes. He sneaks down to the aquarium.
But Gwen does this every day. She and Sylvia go have lunch, and then they go on these long walks through town. They cover the entire city. She says that with Sylvia, she meets all kinds of people from all walks of life. She says she's having the first truly democratic experience of her life.
I thought Gwen was a Republican.
She was. She used to be.
Hamilton is at least that.
I almost wish Gwen would change back.
I think all men should be Republicans, Kate. It seems to be good for their prostate. When Hamilton voted for Bush, why he... I can't wait for the next erection. I mean, election. But I've been talking too much.
I think I hate Sylvia, Phyllis.
No.
I do. I didn't think it was possible to hate anyone except Nixon. But now I hate Sylvia.
She's just a dog, Kate.
I don't care. She's a kangaroo. She's destroying our marriage.
Oh.
I feel doomed, Phyllis, cooped up in this little apartment with that creature.
Then draw the line, Kate. Tell Gwen she's simply got to go.
I've tried. We keep making these clear arrangements, but Gwen keeps breaking them, like Hitler.
Oh, Kate.
I have the terrible feeling I'll be sharing my life with Sylvia for the next 10 years.
Do you think she'll last that long?
I know she will, but I won't. If this continues, she'll stand drooling over my grave.
Hello.
There they are. Phyllis Cutler is here, darling. Now brace yourself.
Why, hello, Phyllis. So good to see you again. This is Sylvia.
Hello, hello. Nice crotch, your nice crotch. Run along, Sylvia.
This is just my way of saying hello.
Stop that, Sylvia.
Down, Sylvia.
Make her get down, Gwen.
Down, Sylvia. No.
See what I'm up against.
I'm beginning to.
She doesn't normally do that.
She does it all the time.
Hey, we learned 3 new tricks today. Want to see them?
We do not.
Phyllis wants to see them, don't you, Phyllis?
Well,
wait! When did you have time to teach Sylvia tricks, Gwen?
I came home early.
Why, Gwen?
To teach Sylvia tricks.
See?
We found a quiet place in the park and we practiced, didn't we, Sylvia?
We did.
All right. First trick. Where's your little red ball, Sylvia?
Huh?
Find your little red ball.
Oh, gotcha. See? Little red ball.
Good girl. Now, give it to Mommy.
Why should I?
Give it to Mommy, Sylvia.
What's in it for me?
You get a treat if you give it to Mommy.
Okay.
Good girl.
Thanks.
Now, catch the ball, Sylvia.
I'm not done with my treat.
Catch the ball, Sylvia.
That was a tough one.
Good girl. Now, go fetch the ball, Sylvia.
Go fetch that ball?
Go fetch that ball.
All right, I will, seeing as how you're God.
See what I'm up against? Notice how conversation ceases. Notice how civilization completely collapses while we wait for Sylvia.
I might just have a small scotch, Kate.
Phyllis.
I want one, Kate. Right now, please.
You're worried, aren't you, Phyllis?
Actually, I am, Gwen.
Don't be. I'm sure she'll find her ball. It's probably behind the hall table. See? What did I tell you?
I am ultimately relieved. Here's the ball, Gwen.
Good girl. Now, when Kate gets back, I want you to roll over.
I don't like rolling over, Gwen.
I know, but I want you to.
Here you are, Phyllis.
Thanks.
Gwen, do you think we might put Sylvia in the
other... Hold it. Watch this. Roll over, Sylvia.
This is the one I don't like, Gwen.
Go on. Do it. Roll over, and you get a treat.
Oh, all right. I'll do it. I feel like a fool, but there you have it.
Good girl.
Hey up, then.
Here you go. See what we accomplished?
Did you like my trick, Phyllis? Down, Sylvia!
Stop that, Sylvia!
Have you tried spanking her? I really don't think there's enough spanking these days.
Gwen, darling, do you think we might put Sylvia in the kitchen? I mean, we want to talk to Phyllis here, don't we?
Wait, one more trick. Speak, Sylvia.
Speak?
Speak, Sylvia.
I'm not sure what she wants here.
Speak, Sylvia. Speak.
Now wait, I'm sure I know this one. I've just forgotten it.
Look at this treat. You can have it if you speak.
It's coming back to me.
Speak, Sylvia.
Hey!
Good girl.
Hey!
Good girl.
Hey!
That's a very good girl. See, sweetie, she can speak.
So much for Shakespeare.
I've got to be off.
But we've hardly talked.
No, really. I've got to go. It was so nice seeing you, Kate. Goodbye, Gwen. Sylvia,
no!
Down, Sylvia. She likes you a lot, Phyllis.
I'll tell them that at my next AA meeting. Stay away, Sylvia.
She is driving away our friends, Gwen.
Oh, come on.
She is. She gave Alice Felker a bloody nose.
She thought Alice was playing.
Well, Alice wasn't. Alice was defending herself.
I'm hungry. When do we eat? It's time to chow down.
Our friends loathe her.
The Wilkins specifically said to bring her next time we come up.
They were just being nice.
They loved her. Most people love her. When we walk down the street, people stop to pat her, and children's faces brighten when we walk by. She lightens my life.
She darkens mine, Gwen.
Where's dinner? I'm gonna go check on dinner.
She's hungry.
I wanna talk about this, Gwen.
We've been all through it, Kate.
We have not been all through it. Did you get fired today, Gwen?
What?
Did you get fired?
No, of course not, no. I got temporarily laid off.
Oh, Gwen.
They gave me a leave of absence for medical reasons.
Medical reasons?
They think I need counseling.
You do, darling. I really think you do.
Just because my job doesn't seem real anymore.
What is real then, Gwen?
Sylvia. Sylvia's real.
I'll tell you what's real, Gwen. The mortgage on this apartment is real. The kids' tuitions are very, very real.
I just need to feel more...
More what, Gwen? And don't say real.
More connected, then.
Connected? Connected to what?
To life. No, living.
Oh, I'm beginning to understand, darling.
You are?
I am. This is just one of those midlife crises.
No, it isn't.
Yes, it is, darling. I'll admit, I'm slightly sauced, but I still know a hawk from a handsaw.
What?
It's like when poor, fat old Ted Donahue tried to take up tap dancing.
This is nothing like that.
Well, I'm sorry, sweetie, but whatever it is, I have to say time is up.
time's up?
Really up. I said I'd try, and I have, and it's been much longer than a few days. So I want you to give Sylvia away.
Away?
I want that. I'm asking that. I insist upon that.
What do you mean, give her away? To whom?
Some farmer. Give her to some farmer.
Farmers don't exist anymore, Kate. Read the New Republic.
Oh, now.
And I'm not having Sylvia taken care of by some agricultural conglomerate. Sylvia being watched by some Archer Daniels Midland? Nope, no way. Sorry, can't do it.
When?
Look what I found.
Oh, Lord, she's got my shoe.
It's a peace offering.
It is not. It's a deliberate act of aggression.
Look at this shoe. Look at this fabulous shoe.
I want that shoe, Sylvia.
Chase me.
She'll ruin it, Gwen.
Chase me.
She just wants to play. Drop that shoe, Sylvia, immediately. Gwen.
Bring it here, Sylvia. Here's your shoe, Kate.
She's ruined it.
It was an old shoe.
It was my best pair. You owe me a pair of new shoes, Gwen.
Okay. I'll buy you a new pair of shoes.
I bet she took my book, too.
What book?
My annotated copy of All's Well That Ends Well. I can't find it. I bet she took it and ate it.
She wouldn't do that.
Hey, hey!
She ate half the New Yorker.
It was a lousy issue anyway. The New Yorker's getting...
Hey, hey, hey!
I'm issuing an ultimatum, Gwen.
It's time for her dinner. Come on, sweetheart.
Sweetheart? Is it sweetheart now? God damn it, Gwen. When's the last time you said that to me?
I believe this is yours.
I have something to say to you, Sylvia.
What if I don't feel like listening?
Then I'll see to it that you never lick another plate again.
All right. Shoot.
Off, Sylvia.
Gwen lets me sit here.
I don't. Now off.
Make me. And I'm warning you, I've been known to bite.
Try that once, Sylvia. Just once, and you are out the door. Now off.
All right, cool it. I get the picture. You sure don't like me, do you?
I think it's safe to say I hate your guts.
May I ask why?
Because you're messing around with my marriage.
Sylvia, time for dinner.
I believe I'm wanted in the kitchen.
Hold it, Sylvia.
Let me go.
I plan to do everything I can to get you out of here.
I doubt you can do very much, Kate.
Before long, you'll be cowering in some cage.
Dinny poo, up, supper time.
My master's voice, Kate.
I'm not through yet, Sylvia. You should know that all you are is a midlife crisis. Oh, sure, it's been so fun and exciting walking around town these fine fall days. But when winter comes and is cold in the morning and dark in the afternoon, when Gwen has to stand shivering in the park to pick up your doo-doo, how long do you think you'll last? Gwen will have second thoughts then, Sylvia, and I'll be right there to help her think them.
Sylvia, down.
You're forgetting one thing, Kate.
Oh, yeah? And what is that?
Gwen loves me.
Really?
Really. She thinks I shit ice cream.
There's love and there's love, sister.
Yeah, well, we'll see.
Yeah, we'll see. From here on in, it's a fight to the finish.
Fair enough. May the best species win.
Hey, great. Can I play too?
Thank you. Thank you.
Welcome to tonight's performance. In order to fully engage with the art...
Don't you want to play with the gang?
I get bored with the afternoon crowd. It's all nannies and babies, schnauzers and cocker spaniels.
What you mean is Bowser hasn't shown up yet.
I mean what I mean.
I wish I knew more about you, Sylvia.
Why do you have to know everything?
Just for the pleasure of knowing. Take Kate, for example. We've been dating since college. We know each other cold.
Yeah, well, that's her. This is me.
I wish I knew more about your former owner.
Second owners always wish that.
Did you like him as much as you like me?
How do you know it was a guy?
Good point. But you were mistreated, weren't you?
I got to sleep on the couch.
Still, what kind of person takes their dog to a park and just lets them go?
How do you know I didn't run away? Or how do you know I didn't see you sitting on this bench and say, "There's the woman I want to spend the rest of my life with.
How do you know I didn't break my leash and run to your side?
I don't know, do I?
And you never will. See, I'm a mystery. I'm what's known as the other, and that's never happened to you before. Which is why it's so exciting, which is what love is all about. Now go with the flow, man. Now I think I'll just mosey on back to the group.
Because Bowser's there now, right?
I'm not saying a word.
Hi, Gwen.
Hi, Tommy.
How are things going at home?
Fine.
Really?
Actually, not so good.
Thought so. Think I know why.
Sylvia's why.
No, it's deeper than that. I've been reading this book.
Another book.
This one's deep, man. It's all about us.
Us?
It says we're basically biophilic.
Hey, watch it.
No. That's a good thing, man. People who love dogs are biophiles. They're lovers of the bios, which is Greek for the processes of nature.
Go on.
What's more, the whole thing's genetic. Did your dad take you hiking and fishing as a kid?
Actually, yes.
Did your ma push your stroller through some zoo?
I'm sure, yes.
See, what they were doing was activating your biophilic gene.
I see.
We've inherited these genes from our caveman days when we had to connect with nature in order to survive it. And your relationship with Sylvia has reactivated that gene. That's why you respond to her so strongly. On the other hand, your wife's biophilic gene has become thoroughly atrophied.
That's true enough.
She sees nature as threatening and messy.
You got it.
That's why you're having marital problems.
I don't know, Tommy.
Look, I'm just giving you a name for what's going on. Naming the problem helps you deal with the problem. Actually, that's why me and my wife decided to split.
Oh, I'm sorry.
No, it's good. Biophiles need to mate with other biophiles. It's better for the environment. Bowser and I are hoping to hook up with a forestry major.
Good luck.
I'll lend you the book.
Sylvia's having a ball out there.
Life of the party, isn't she?
She's been to the beauty parlor again.
Or else she's in heat.
Nah.
She may be.
What makes you think that?
The way she carries her tush. Did you ever get her spayed?
Not yet. I took your advice about waiting. Is Bowser neutered?
Nope, it's different.
Is it?
Call her. See if she'll come.
Of course she'll come.
Not if she's in heat.
Sylvia! Sylvia, come! See, she's coming immediately.
Hi, Gwen. Hello, Tommy. Did I ever tell you how fond I am of Bowser?
You're not in heat, are you, sweetheart?
Me? Nah, no way.
Didn't think so.
I just think about sex all the time. That's all.
She seems to be asking for it.
She's just being affectionate.
Sex.
She's definitely in heat.
It's just natural affection.
May I go now?
Sure, kid. Go on.
Oh, boy. Ready or not, Bowser, here I come, and I want your lovin' too sweet.
You may be right. She may be in heat.
I think she is.
Well, what do I do if she is?
Keep her inside.
With my wife?
Then send her away.
My wife?
Sylvia!
Out of the question.
Then keep her on a leash at all times, and don't bring her to the park. If you let her loose, you're just asking for it.
That bastard!
Who, Bowser?
He raped her!
Come off it!
Bowser raped Sylvia!
She asked for it! She practically shoved it right in his face!
Listen, fella, you're talking about my... dog.
See what we're doing? Thinking of them as people.
Right.
After this, you should have her fixed.
And you should have Bowser neutered.
Nope, sorry. It'd ruin his personality. There's a major difference between castration and just having her tubes tied, Gwen. Think about it.
Oh, I see. So once again, the women of this world are being asked to suffer the consequences of male aggression. I'll tell you what, Tommy, I'm learning a lot about life these days.
Cool it, Gwen.
Oh, Sylvia. Do these things always take...
Not always.
I almost wish it would.
Why?
Sylvia'd make a wonderful mother.
It's tough having puppies, particularly in the city.
But I'd be there for her. I'd pitch right in. I'd build her a special box with a blanket and a newspaper. It'd give us more in common. Why, let me tell you. When Kate and I had our kids, I pulled my weight. I helped feed them and bathe them and change their diapers. And on Sunday mornings, we pulled them under the covers and we'd all hunker down together. I'd do the same for Sylvia and her pups. Why, we'd all... together we'd... Why, Weed?
You're sick, man.
I know it.
Get her to a vet first thing.
Right.
And get yourself to a shrink.
Mm-hmm.
Well, looks like they're done. Hey, it's late. Come on, Bowser. Shake a leg. A studly one.
You macho bastard. Well, well.
You speaking to me?
Did you have a good time out there?
I believe it's time to go home.
I said, did you have a good time?
I'd prefer not to discuss it.
Do you like Bowser?
Who?
You know damn well who. That big guy walking off with his tail up heading home.
Oh, him.
Do you like him?
It's really none of your business, Gwen.
Oh, really? Seems to me you made it everyone's business out there.
Look, Gwen, I happen to be exhausted.
I'll bet you are.
I am tired and I am hungry, and I do not want to stand around this park discussing ancient history. What happened between me and Bowser is over and done with. It was just a fling, just a silly fling. We both got temporarily carried away. Now let's leave it at that.
Will it happen again?
What do you mean?
Are you still in heat, Sylvia?
I refuse to recognize that expression. I find it somewhat demeaning.
You are, aren't you?
I'm not saying I am. I'm not saying I'm not.
Seems to me a little operation is in order.
Which means?
Never mind, but I'm calling the vet first thing.
Sounds like you plan to punish me.
No.
It certainly sounds that way.
That's for your own good, Sylvia.
Oh, yeah, sure. Tell me another.
I just wish you would exercise a little more self-control.
May we change the subject, please? May we get on with our lives? And may we make some attempt to move towards home, because I happen to be quite hungry.
I'll bet you are. Let's go.
Hold it.
What?
Get a load of that Dalmatian.
What about him?
Look at the butt on that guy.
Let's go, Sylvia.
On second thought, maybe I want to stay.
Oh, it is straight under the knife for you, kid. First thing.
You're jealous, aren't you?
Not at all.
Yes, you are. You're jealous.
I am not. I just happen to think you could do better. That's all.
Yeah.
Is that you, darling?
Just us.
Gwen, I wonder if we might talk for a minute.
Sure, we can talk. Come on, Sylvia.
Alone, Gwen. Without Sylvia.
She'll be quiet. She's still a little under the weather after her operation.
I feel like a gutted turkey.
The vet said she'd be shaky a couple more days.
I wish I knew what you had them do to me, you prick.
She's a little mad at me.
Gwen, sweetheart, I have some...
Wait. Lie down, Sylvia.
I don't want to lie down.
Lie down, Sylvia. She's supposed to lie down. Lie down, Sylvia.
Shit, that hurts.
Gwen, I have some very exciting...
Sit, Kate.
What?
I said sit.
I'm not Sylvia, Gwen.
Sorry, I got confused.
Now, Gwen, I have some very exciting news for the both of us.
Shoot.
I got a grant.
You got a grant?
To study in England.
Hey!
It's from this special foundation set up to help women who resume their careers after their childbearing years.
That's great. It's all coming together. Night classes when the kids were still in school, summer school, it's all coming around.
So I thought I'd use it to see how the English teach their mother tongue.
Great idea.
And?
And?
They supply a spousal supplement.
A spousal supplement?
You can come too. And it couldn't have happened at a better time, with your job in limbo and everything.
Perfect.
I thought we'd get a flat in London and maybe have the kids over for the summer.
Oh, to be in England. Hikes on the moors, Wuthering Heights, the Hound of the Baskervilles.
Oh, don't talk to me. I'm dying here.
Just close your eyes and think of England, Sylvia. The English are great people. They love dogs.
They do, darling. They definitely do. They love them so much that they're very protective of their own.
What does that mean?
There's a quarantine, sweetheart. A 6-month quarantine before you can bring a dog into the country.
That's ridiculous.
Well, there is. I checked. I called the consulate. Even Elizabeth Taylor's dogs weren't allowed to set paw on English soil.
You're saying we can't take Sylvia?
I'm afraid not, Gwen.
Those snooty, limey bastards. So Sylvia's not good enough for them, huh?
We'll just have to find her a good home, Gwen. Let sleeping dogs lie, Gwen.
You applied for this grant, didn't you?
Of course I applied for it.
No, I mean recently. Since Sylvia?
As a matter of fact, yes.
And you specifically asked for England.
English is my field, sweetheart.
And you knew that Sylvia couldn't come.
I knew we needed to get away, Gwen.
You were trying to separate me from my dog.
Yes, that is a part of it.
That is a major part of it.
She's not good for us. I hate what she does to you, and I hate what she does to me. I think... What is that awful smell?
I think it's Sylvia. The vet said she might pass a little gas.
Damn it, Sylvia!
She's had an operation, Kate.
I want to talk about England, Gwen.
I don't want to go.
If you loved me, you would come.
I'll come visit.
I followed you around for 20 years. You can damn well follow me.
I said I'll visit.
I plan to be there for 6 months.
That long?
That long.
I'll last.
Maybe I won't.
Are you serious?
You could find her a good home if you wanted to, Gwen.
This is her home. This is my home.
Even without me in it?
I can't leave her, Kate. It's a genetic thing. I have this gene.
Oh, yeah, Gwen. Well, I have a gene, too. It's a gene that tells me I made a major commitment to my mate. It's a gene that tells me I'm responsible for educating my offspring. It's a gene that makes me want to do something constructive about the welfare of the world at large.
Maybe we should sleep on it.
Maybe we should. Going to bed. Are you coming?
Later.
This is serious, isn't it?
I think it is.
Well, thanks a lot, Sylvia. You've managed to chew a huge hole into a 22-year-old relationship.
Hey, Bowser. Wait for me, buddy.
Wake up, Sylvia.
Huh? Who? What? Where?
Time for your pill, kid.
I hate pills.
I'll put it in your food. You won't taste a thing.
I love you.
I'm a mess, Sylvia.
I know you are, but even when you behave like a complete asshole, I love you completely.
I must say, Kate, I find it somewhat difficult to counsel married couples when one of the partners refuses to cooperate. I thought your wife agreed to join us.
She said she would be here.
Then let's simply assume she's late.
Let's simply assume she's with Sylvia. Oh, Leslie, maybe I should just say to hell with the whole thing.
Now, don't give up. We've come a long way, you and I. Please sit, Kate.
I wish people would stop telling me to sit.
All right, stand then. But let's take advantage of Gwen's absence to review the bidding. During our last session, you seem to have suggested that she had actually fallen in love with Sylvia.
She has. Totally.
Couldn't you be exaggerating?
No. She says things to her that she never says to me.
Such as?
You look beautiful. You look wonderful. I love you. All that.
Do you think she's speaking to you through Sylvia, Kate? Maybe Sylvia is simply the medium for which she expresses her love for you.
No, this is different, Leslie. Even when we were first married, she never looked at me the way she looks at Sylvia.
And could you describe that look?
There's a sort of deep, distant light behind her eyes. A sort of primeval affection.
Do you think... Now, how shall I put this, Kate? Do you think there's anything physical in her relationship with Sylvia?
No.
You're sure? These things happen. There was a couple in here just the other day who did very peculiar things with their cat.
There is nothing physical going on between Gwen and Sylvia. Oh, sure, there's a lot of patting and pawing and stroking and licking. That goes on ad nauseum. But nothing beyond that. I almost wish there were.
And why do you say that?
Because then this would just be an affair. And any wife worth her salt can deal with that. But this is different, Leslie. I feel like I'm up against something that's gone on for hundreds of thousands of years. Ever since the first wolf came out of the forest and hunkered down next to the caveman by his fire.
But don't you think that the cave woman must have had ways of shooing the wolf back into outer darkness?
I've tried. That's what I got the grant for. But it only aggravated the issue. Now Gwen loves Sylvia even more. Gwen says there's nothing that becomes Sylvia like the leaving thereof, and so she won't leave her.
But I believe I hear Gwen.
Hello, darling. Sorry I'm late.
This is Leslie, Gwen.
Hello, Leslie. The reason I'm late is that Sylvia had to have her stitches removed.
We don't want to hear it, Gwen.
No. Let her talk. You've had your say. She should have hers.
Well, while we were at the vet, we discovered that Sylvia has worms, which explains why she's been rubbing her butt on the floor. But we plan to treat it with little pink pills.
See what I have to deal with?
Kate, why don't you go into the other room and read a book? I'd like to talk to Gwen alone, if I may.
Is there a phone out there? I might as well just call and reconfirm my single seat on British Airlines.
No, trust me. I've been in this business a long time.
She won't listen. It's impossible to get through.
Please sit, Gwen.
Thank you.
Talk to me, Gwen. Say whatever is on your mind.
Well, she hasn't been herself lately.
I'm glad you can see that, Gwen.
Particularly these last few weeks.
And why do you think that is, Gwen?
Oh, I know why. She resents me.
And why do you suppose she resents you?
Because I made the decision.
What decision?
To have her spayed.
You're talking about...
Sylvia.
Sylvia.
You don't want me to talk about Sylvia?
No, I do. If you want to, Gwen.
Kate doesn't like when I do.
Well, that's Kate. As for me, I'd like very much to hear about Sylvia. Because in telling me about Sylvia, you are actually telling me about yourself.
Well, to begin, she's got these great eyes.
Sylvia?
Sylvia. I finally understand the meaning of the word limpid. She's got limpid, deep, serious eyes. But that doesn't mean she's serious all the time. She laughs. I've actually heard her laugh. And when we walk down the street, everyone always comments on her butt. She's got a great little butt. People stop to pat her just because of it. And when we go to the park, the gang goes nuts for her. Even though she's been spayed, they still love her. Oh, and I found this poem Shakespeare wrote about her.
Shakespeare?
Who is Sylvia? What is she that all our swains commend
Gwen.
Her? Holy, fair, and wise is she.
Gwen.
The heaven such grace.
Gwen.
Yes?
I'm afraid we're confined to the 50-minute hour.
Sorry, I get carried away.
Gwen, I'm going to do something here which I normally do much further along in the therapy process. I'm going to put myself in the picture.
Yourself?
What is my name, Gwen?
Kate said it was Leslie.
Leslie it is, Gwen. Now, am I a man or a woman?
You're a woman.
You hesitated, Gwen.
Yes. Well, sorry.
No. I wanted you to hesitate. I wanted you to select my gender. That's why I call myself Leslie. It's a name that works either way.
I guess it does.
And that's why I wear these androgynous clothes. I may be a man pretending to be a woman, or I may be a woman pretending to be a man. I let my patient select my gender.
I thought you were a woman.
Because you wanted me to be a woman.
I did.
We project our needs onto the world. Life is shapeless and absurd. We use words, names, and categories to give us a sense of shape. We need that sense of shape to get through the day.
Okay.
You can even see it in the Bible, Gwen. God has Adam name the animals so that Adam can construct order out of the chaos around him.
I see.
Which brings us to your dog, Gwen.
Sylvia.
Sylvia. You wanted your dog to be a woman. That's why you named her Sylvia.
She was already named Sylvia.
But you embraced the name. Because you needed a woman.
I already have a woman. Her name is Kate.
But you wanted a different kind of woman, Gwen. You wanted the obedient little wife you once kept in the suburbs. You wanted the worshipful daughter who once hung on your every word. You wanted a Sylvia, Gwen. If Sylvia didn't exist, you'd have to invent her.
You think so?
I do, Gwen. Now, these are what we therapists call the dangerous years.
The dangerous years?
The years between the first hint of retirement and the first whiff of a nursing home.
Oh, God.
No. We should make the most out of these years. I, for example, am moving beyond the boundaries of gender identification. Kate is moving past child rearing to a career in the public classroom. You, on the other hand, seem to have retreated into a kind of pastoral nostalgia.
Pastoral nostalgia?
By acquiring Sylvia.
You think that's true?
I do, Gwen. And I think it's time to move on. I think it's time to accept the challenges that come with later life.
Maybe so.
Drop the leash, Gwen, and once again take hold of your wife's hand. See if you are capable of walking with her, side by side, toward the setting sun.
Thank you, Leslie. This all makes a lot of sense.
I think it does, Gwen. I think it makes a great deal of sense. Now, I must say I'm exhausted. It's been a long, tough haul for us all. Now, if we could bring in Kate so we can sit down together and work through a few specifics.
Well, don't you think you're forgetting one thing?
What thing?
Sylvia.
Sylvia?
You've talked to Kate, you've talked to me, now don't you think you should talk to Sylvia?
You want me to hold a session with your dog?
Not a session. Jesus, Leslie, what kind of a nutcase do you think I am? No, I just think you should pat her, play with her, maybe take her for a walk, because then you'll see, Leslie.
See what?
You'll see that Sylvia is more than a name or a gene or a psychological symptom or anything else that tries to pin her down. Every dog owner knows this, and if you don't, Leslie, I suggest you get one. We should all have dogs. It should be in the Constitution. It's not a right, it's an obligation. When you register to vote, you pick up your dog license. The world would be a much better place. Why, just think. You and me and Nelson Mandela and Yasser Arafat and Meryl Streep could all meet up at Club Med or someplace, and what would we talk about? Our dogs, Leslie, our dogs.
Gwen.
Yes?
I'd like you to leave, quickly if you would, and send Kate in on your way out.
It's Sylvia's dinner time anyway.
What happened?
Kate, I want you to do several things.
Several?
First, I want you to divorce Gwen.
Divorce?
Take her for every nickel she's got.
Oh, I couldn't.
Then I want you to get a gun.
A gun?
To shoot Sylvia. I have to get her right between the eyes.
But...
Sorry, I'm late for my shrink.
If this were to be played out on the stage right now, I'd condemn it as an improbable fiction. Twelfth Night, Act 3.
You are looking particularly glamorous today, Sylvia.
Why, thank you, Gwen.
You know why, don't you?
Tell me while I check out Le Cubelle du jour.
You are looking particularly glamorous today because we have come to a major moment in our relationship.
A major moment?
A turning point of sorts. And at turning points in our lives, good or bad, we instinctively shine. Our hair glistens, our eyes sparkle, and our bodies seem to know.
But why is this a turning point?
We're going to lay out all of our cards. Both of us.
I thought we always did that anyway.
We did. We do. But this will be even more so. Before, you'd been saying what I hoped you would say. Now, I want you to feel as if you are totally on your own.
Sounds exciting.
Would you like to sit, Sylvia?
Where should I sit?
Anywhere you'd like.
May I sit on the couch?
You may. I'll even give you a hand.
This is the life, Gwen. I like these major moments.
I have to send you away, Sylvia.
Away?
To someplace else.
Oh, you mean that kennel you put me in when you went away on that weekend. I can live with that, as long as it's not for too long.
It's not a kennel, Sylvia. I've found a family for you.
Oh, fine. Sounds even better than a kennel.
And it won't be for just a few days.
How long? 2 weeks? Three?
Forever, Sylvia.
Forever?
It boils down to this. You or Kate, and I'm choosing Kate.
You're choosing Kate?
I have to.
But you can't have us both?
I guess I can't.
Is this because she hates me?
She doesn't hate you, Sylvia.
She sure doesn't like me.
She doesn't like me when I'm with you.
Lord knows I've tried to please her.
You have.
I always greet her when she comes home.
I know that, Sylvia.
And she seems to like it when I lick the plates before they go in the dishwasher. She even encourages the habit.
That's only because she doesn't like waste, Sylvia.
So you're choosing her over me?
She's my wife. She's the other mother of my children. We've lived together a very long time.
Do you love her?
I do. Very much.
I thought you loved me.
I do, sweetheart, but in a different way, and not in a good way as far as Kate is concerned.
I thought there was talk of you and me moving out.
There was talk of that, yes.
I thought there was serious talk of you and me getting a studio apartment over on 69th Street, right near the park.
There was, in the heat of the moment.
And we were going to go on a camping trip up to Chesapeake Bay, and you were going to teach me how to retrieve ducks.
I was going to do all of those things.
Now suddenly you've just chickened out?
That's what I've done. I've chickened out.
I feel awful.
So do I.
Know what I wish I could do? Mix myself a double absolute vodka on the rocks with a twist.
I did that for myself earlier.
Yeah, well, being a dog, I don't happen to have the solace of alcohol, Gwen.
I've got a bark bar for you.
A what?
A bark bar. I got you one on our last walk to the east side. You loved it. Remember?
It's shaped like a cat.
I thought you'd be amused by that.
Amused? Amused by those bastards? Well, doesn't look bad, but not good enough. So, tell me about this family you're shipping me off to.
You're going to love them. I put an ad in the Westchester News, and I interviewed a number of applicants.
Thanks for letting me in on it.
You're going to live in the suburbs, Sylvia.
I hate the suburbs.
What? All that green grass? This family has half an acre, all fenced in.
That Akita in the park used to live in the suburbs. He says you're totally alone out there. There's no sense of being part of a pack, and if you do meet someone while on a walk, you'll probably get run over.
You won't want to go on walks, Sylvia. You'll want to stay close to home.
Why?
Because you're going to love this family so much.
Why?
Well, they've got kids.
How many?
Three.
Any babies?
One.
I hate babies.
You don't. You're always licking their faces.
Their mouths taste good, but they're always stepping on your tail.
Well, there's two teenagers. They're eager to have you. They want to take you to Little League games and teach you to play Frisbee. They'll be better for you than I ever could be.
I hate teenagers.
You don't.
I do. I hate them. They're totally unreliable. They forget to feed you. They play music, which hurts your ears. One minute, they're showering you with affection. And the next, they're leaving you in some hot car for hours on end. Oh, Gwen, please don't do this to me. Don't send me away. Keep me here with you, please.
I can't, Sylvia.
But I'll change. I'll change my ways. I'll stop chewing shoes. I'll bring Kate the New York Times every morning. Well, I won't do that. That's too cheesy. But I'll do something else. Just tell me what to do and I'll do it, I swear.
I promised Kate I would send you away. I made that promise to my wife.
When?
Today.
Today?
I'm taking you away right now.
I can't even say goodbye to Bowser?
You just saw him in the park.
Jesus, you're something, Gwen. You know that? You really are. You bring me home. You get me all dependent on you. You spay me.
Sylvia!
You had me spayed. You destroyed my sense of womanhood. And when I get over that, when I still decide the sun rises and sets only in your direction, then you're shipping me off to some nuclear family in Westchester County. I mean, Christ, Gwen, don't you feel guilty about this?
I do. I feel awful.
I mean, shit, you have a moral obligation here. What would they say at the Humane Society? How would they react at the ASPCA?
They'd say I'm doing the right thing.
Oh, bullshit. That's just bullshit, Gwen.
They'd say a week out there and you'd forget all about me.
Never!
Really, I might come to visit and you'd come up for a pat and a sniff and that would be that.
You're so wrong, Gwen. You're so goddamn wrong. Read the Odyssey sometime. That guy was gone 20 years, and when he gets back, the first person to recognize him, before his nurse, before his son, before his own wife, goddammit, was his dog. That dog was lying outside the palace all those years just waiting for him, Gwen. Lying in a dung heap waiting for his master. And when his master finally shows up, what does the dog do? He raises his head, wags his tail, and dies.
Oh, don't, Sylvia.
I'll never forget you, Gwen, ever.
Please, Sylvia, I can't take this.
All right, then. Let's get this over with. I'll have to rely on the kindness of strangers. Send me to the suburbs. Hope I can at least sit with you in the front seat on the way there, considering Her Majesty won't be there to object.
Hello?
Or will she?
What's she doing home?
Christ, I feel like sneaking off and hiding under some bed.
I thought you had a meeting.
It broke up early.
We're just getting ready to leave now.
Where's Saliva?
Sylvia, Kate.
Where is she?
At the moment, I imagine she's trying to stay out of your hair.
Gwen.
Yes?
I know this is hard for you.
Damn right.
I want you to know that I appreciate it.
Thanks.
We'll have a great time in England, Gwen. It'll be a whole new thing.
I don't want to talk about it right now. It's too painful at the moment.
Do you plan to take all her stuff?
It's all in a bag in the front hall.
Her bed, her brush, her kibble dish?
It's all there.
What about her little red ball?
I couldn't find it.
She liked that little red ball.
At least you noticed.
It's a shame to send her off without it.
She'll survive.
Actually, Gwen, my meeting is still going on. I ducked out early.
Oh, yes?
I thought I should come home and say goodbye.
To Saliva?
To Sylvia.
Why?
I wanted to.
Magnanimous in victory, eh?
Gwen.
Fine. Have your farewell scene. Sylvia, come! I don't think she wants to. Sylvia!
You called?
Kate wants to say goodbye to you.
Oh, sure. And I'm Maria Vermania.
Come, Sylvia.
Who's she kidding?
Go on. She's human. Say goodbye.
I know it's been tough sledding between you and me, Sylvia, but I do want to say goodbye.
What is this? Some sudden sisterhood thing?
Easy now.
I wish it could have been otherwise.
So do I. May I go now?
We'll be off then.
Maybe stop at the pet store and get her another little red ball on the way? All's well that ends well.
Whatever.
And it's in reasonably good condition. There's just one chew mark on the corner here.
She found it in the hall closet and insisted on bringing it right in.
You found it and sent her in with it.
Suit yourself, Kate. I'll call the garage.
I'll be right with you. I've been thinking about what you said, Kate.
What I said?
I wish it could have been otherwise. I've been thinking about that. Know what otherwise is, Kate? Otherwise, it's that man who ran off with his grandchildren's au pair. Or that guy who took a shot at his wife while she was doing her step aerobics. Or those sad couples sitting together night after night in restaurants, eyeing each other with absolutely nothing to say. That's otherwise, Kate.
Is it, Sylvia?
Yes, it is. And I'll tell you what thiswise is, Kate. Thiswise is the fact that Gwen can never be happy with me unless you like me too. Which is why she's always foisting me on you, which is called sharing, which is what some people call love. That's this wise, Kate.
Let's go, Sylvia.
Of course. What do I know? I'm only a dog.
Oh, as Shakespeare once said, what the hell?
Never made it to the suburbs. We called and said we'd changed our minds. They were understanding, being dog lovers like ourselves.
And I changed my mind about England. Oh, I went. For a couple weeks. But mostly I stayed here.
And Sylvia stayed. She stayed with us for the next 11 years until everything went wrong and we had to put her to sleep. I held her in my arms when the vet gave her the shot. She looked at me, laid down, gave a little sigh, and died. When I got home, Kate was waiting for me, and we both cried.
That's not true. I did not cry.
You did. You just won't admit it.
I'm sorry to say that Sylvia and I never really got along, even later on.
You got along famously.
We tolerated each other, if that.
Once, I got home from my new job at Wildlife Conservation International, and I found Kate and Sylvia side by side on the couch.
This is an absolute lie.
Kate was reading The Hidden Life of Dogs, and Sylvia had her head in Kate's lap.
This is a total fantasy.
I'll tell you something else. Over the years, something strange happened. Sylvia and I didn't talk as much.
Now this is true.
Oh, we talked, but it was as if we learned to understand each other without communicating. Or maybe it was that we learned we could never understand each other.
Or maybe it's because you and I talked more.
Maybe. Sylvia's looks changed, too.
They did. She began to look, well, different. Show them the picture.
I'll show you her picture. There. That's Sylvia.
I took that picture the year before she died.
No, who took the picture?
I'm afraid she looks a little worse for wear.
That is not true, Kate. She still looks absolutely stunning. Ah, Sylvia.
Oh, Sylvia.